So after the discussion about the medial longitudinal arch, now we start discussion about the lateral longitudinal arch of the foot. Here, the bony components are, here is this is calcaneum. Here is lateral tubercle. This is lateral tubercle of calcaneum. Lateral tubercle of calcaneum. Here is superior articular surface of the calcaneum. Here is cuboid. This is cuboid. This is fifth, this is fourth, fifth and fourth metatarsal. So these four bones of the foot form the lateral longitudinal arch. Ends of this arch, this is anterior end, this is posterior end. Anterior end is formed by this head of fifth and head of fourth metatarsal. This form anterior end, and posterior end is formed by lateral tubercle of the calcaneum and pillars. Anterior pillar is formed by this structure, fifth, fourth metatarsal and cuboid bone. Posterior pillar is strong and is formed by calcaneum. And summit of this joint is present here at the superior articular surface of the calcaneum. And main joint is calcaneo cuboid joint. This joint is main joint of this lateral longitudinal arch. Calcaneo cuboid joint. Now factors responsible for maintaining the longitudinal arch, lateral longitudinal arch. Here is these two structures. Here is short and long plantar ligament. Short and long plantar ligament forms intersegmental tie. These two structures, long and short plantar ligament, long and short, these two ligaments form intersegmental tie. These two structures connect these bony components. And here, this is plantar aponeurosis. This plantar aponeurosis, it forms tie beam. It holds two ends of this arch, anterior and posterior ends of the arch. And another component which is responsible for maintaining the arch that is sling. Sling, this structure, this is tendon of peroneus brevis and peroneus longus. This tendon of peroneus longus, it passes through the groove present on inferior aspect of the cuboid. From here, it passes from inferior aspect of the stool and it goes towards the medial side, and here it is attached to this from lateral side to come to here and attach to this, form a complete stirrup or string which holds the joint. So this form the sling which supports the joint and holds the summit upward. So these are peroneus longus tendon and peroneus brevis tendon. So again, if these plantar ligaments become weak, this become weak, then there is flat foot, that is pes planus, in case of contraction of these short and long plantar and plantar epidermis, or these structures, contracture of these structures form the pes cavus, that is high arch foot. So this is all about the lateral longitudinal arch of the foot.